is lecture 9, continuing of the lecture 8, I must say that what is the need of formal language? So what is the language? Language, it may be spoken language. The rules are generally of type 0. I will again explain what is type 0 languages. Type 0 is very difficult to, it is easy to generate, but to understand, accept, it is difficult. So before formal language and automata theory, what is automata? Automata is there to accept a string, and grammar is on the reverse side to generate the string. So grammar with some production rules will generate a string subterminals, and that has to be accepted by a automaton or automata. The simplest is the finite state machine, and then it can see only the regular grammar can be accepted and thoroughly accepted, no doubt about it. But that is very useful, like we use in regular expression, like whenever you find to search a particular particular C programming in a Unix, like ls *c, that *start* is a expression, regular expression. We generally use this knowingly and unknowingly in DOS commands and in and the Unix command, in Unix grep command, in Unix ls command, we use that regular expression. But regular expression is a language, but you cannot write a procedural programming into it. Why? Because the regular expressions have only a b star or a star b, a to the power n, b to the power n, where m and n rule relation, that is regular expression. But whenever a to the power n, b to the power n, it is not a regular language, because you are comparing n and another n. So when you are have to comparing this kind of thing, there is a to the power n, b to the power n, or a to the power 2n, b to the power 2n. A to the power 2n means a with 2n repetition, b with 2n repetition. Whenever you are comparing, then you need a infinite stack. Then your finite state machine, along with the infinite stack, it measure the a to the power n items. So that is a push down automata, and then the language is the grammar is the deterministic context free grammar. The left hand side variable as a regular grammar is a single variable. In regular grammar, right hand side, any terminal or a variable, that is called right linear grammar, or a variable of any terminals, that is left linear grammar, but the both rules cannot be there. And in the, this is a type 3 grammar, and in type 2 grammar, this is the left hand side again a context free, is a single variable, and right hand side anything, any concatenation of all these things. So that is the beginning of formal language, because in English we can say this kind of thing, the boy saw a girl with a telescope, say boy saw a girl with a telescope, or boy saw a girl who we have a telescope. So this kind of double meaning thing is good for literature. In any literature, if it is means everything, then there will be no layers of emotion, all these things. But it is good for, say, writing poetry, writing prose, but that is not good for writing a program which should be run on an automata. So whenever you wish to run a program on automata, the language should be generated by production rules, and it has to be accepted by hardware. So that is the introduction to the formal language. The formal language should not have any ambiguity. See here, in our English language, say English language is very simple language and very easy to learn. I am telling you, it is much easier than Tamil and Bengali, even Sanskrit. English language very easy. What it says is a noun phrase and verb phrase. Any sentence can consist of noun phrase first, then verb phrase. There is some adjective phrase, adverb phrase, prepositional phrase, that I remember. These things are almost you can brought into programming languages. So you see, nowadays all programming languages, see the Python, it is almost like English language. That is the advantage of this all English, Latin, this kind of languages. The rules can be written in context-free grammar. And in our Sanskrit or Bengali, it will be context-sensitive. Context-sensitive grammar means your left-hand side, any combination of variable and terminal, right-hand side, any variable time domain, which is very difficult. So that is the thing. The example of phase structure grammar. See, this has this name has given phase structure given by Noam Chomsky. So this noun phrase and verb phrase, and this I have covered in my earlier lecture. Please see that. This is the grammar. A grammar is a powerful tool for describing and analyzing language. I have covered in the last class, and the notes are also given to you. Yes, this is for definition of a grammar for all class, a type 0, type 1, type 2, type 3 grammar. Why the grammar is required? The grammar is required. You have to create infinite language with some production rules P. As per the production rules, grammar you can say type 3 grammar when the left hand side only one variable, right hand side at the end the variable is only, then you call right linear grammar. Or if the variable at the beginning and less terminal, then left linear grammar. Easiest of the grammar that we call the regular grammar, type 3 grammar, regular expression, non-deterministic finite automata, deterministic finite automata, all can be combined together in regular grammar. But one disadvantage of regular grammar is you cannot write a procedural programming, you cannot write if then else statement, because if then else, then and else to be matched. Whenever there's a matching comes, you need a push down automata. Anyway, last class I have already covered. In some of the books, this is called variable. Some of the books is NT, non-terminals, particularly CIFSAR, in COHOBI is a variable. These are all same. And what I also wish to mention, the V is a variable, a definitely finite set, alphabet, you know, all the finite set, P finite set, but all this finite set can generate infinite sentences, valid sentences by application of P. So your start variable is S, and by application P again and again recursively, you can generate infinite number of sentences. But that infinity is, you know, there are two kinds of infinity. One is you can numerable, so that you can count like integer numbers, so the 1, 2, 3, 4. So that kind of infinity, not the infinity of real numbers. Between 1 and 2, there are bigger kind of infinity and bigger infinity. And if you see the count each integer 1, 2, 3, there's a smaller infinity. So anyway, through these production rules, you can generate infinite of valid sentences. That valid sentences, if it is from a regular grammar, then it can be accepted by deterministic finite automata. And all these things I have covered in last class. This thing I want to mention, though these are finite, but actual grammar is nothing but creation, and automata is for accept. Like grammar is creating some balls and catching is by automata. So both should match. Yeah, the formal language I told that in some books it is non-terminal and some books it is V. It is now clear to you, I believe. This is Noam Chomsky hardware. This is Noam Chomsky hierarchy. Sorry, that this is the type 3 grammar. Type 3 grammar, regular, deterministic finite automata, non-deterministic finite automata, all are same. Regular grammar, regular expressions, all are same. See the production rules. Left hand side one and only variable. Right hand side a terminal only or a variable at the end. This is called right linear grammar. Okay, and type 2 grammar, you need it. This is very useful grammar that is called context free. It is also a context free. Left hand side no context, here also no context, but we call it irregular. And this side, the variable can be anywhere. Okay, variable can be at anywhere, not at the end or at the beginning. It can be at any place. That is called context free grammar. That is the most of the programming languages are formed with the context free grammar only. A grammar is a right linear grammar that I wish to tell again and again. A grammar is said to be right linear if all the productions of the form, like left hand side one variable, right hand side x is a terminal and v is a variable, or a is big and x is a terminal. See, here x is a terminal or a string of terminals. Here it can be a single terminal or a string of terminals. Yes, it is a string of terminals. See, always generally we see x, y, z is a string of terminals. A grammar is said to be left linear if all the production rules in the left is the variable is string of terminals. Yes, that I mentioned last class also. This See, this kind of, whenever you say a to the power n or b to the power n, or instead of a and b, use 0 to the power n, 1 to the power n. 0 to the power n means 0 with n number of type occasions and 1 with n number of type occasions. This is a typical matching parenthesis grammar. Whenever you make a C program, you need a open parenthesis and must be match number of parentheses open and number of parentheses match. This has the final, this must be checked syntax analysis phase of a compiler. So you need a stack to match number of zeros and ones. So this is L2 is a not regular language. It is called deterministic context free language. I'll tell what is deterministic and non-deterministic context free language. And this one is much tougher language. Say we have a sentence ABC or another ABC, whether it is coming from a rule, this is context sensitive, and you need a bounded Turing machine. It's called linear bounded automata for this. This is another higher kind of, this kind of grammar is hardly used in programming language because it's very tough to resolve this. So most of the grammars of the programming languages coming from regular grammar, like regular grammar comes whenever declaration of variables, that is a job of regular grammar, and whenever you write a opening braces parenthesis, this is comes from the if then else structure. It is deterministic context free grammar. This is a type 3. Now we are focusing on type 3, easiest of this. Here everything is in polynomial problem. Polynomial is easily solvable. Polynomial means n squared is a polynomial problem. Here I have last class, this is a regular language and this is a deterministic. All programming languages, 99% of programming languages comes within this. And here these are the languages we generally talk and write in English, maybe here. But it is very difficult to understand the computer. Whatever computer we have developed through this after Turing machine, it can go up to this, or maybe up to this, not this. These are the type 0 grammar. Here it is a type 3, this is type 2, okay, this is type 2, these both are type 2, and this is type 1 and type 0. I'll come, this is jobs, but this is very tough to programming. I've covered in last class, that is a combinatorial circuit. No feedback, this is regular grammar. This I have covered. Yes, the language is regular if and only if, that I say, is a finite state. So, regular and finite state, remember, the same. Context free is a catch, is context free is two type, deterministic context free and non-deterministic context free. Non-deterministic context free is much more powerful, unlike our non-deterministic finite state machine. Context-free grammar is related with push-down automata. Context-sensitive grammar, where the left-hand side variable with some another variable or terminal, it is a linear-bounded Turing machine. And phase-structure grammar, that is the ultimate, that's a Turing machine. So regular grammar we have covered. So this is for this class, lecture 9 ends here. Thank you for being here.